Hey there. I'm on the northeastern shore of the Tihon Peninsula, inside Lake Wollaton, and today I'm planning to explore social distancing in the Middle Ages. So you might wonder what the hell is he talking about, but I will not tell it to you right now because I want to build up some suspense, you know. Okay, so I'll have to cross this road and then I have to go up this hill. You can see here, there's a little, you can see I left my bike here, and there is this hiking trail, and this will lead us hopefully to an interesting historical place that might allow us to explore social distancing, or at least one way of social distancing in the Middle Ages. The place I'm going to visit is called Borat Lakások in Hungarian. I'm sorry, I know my Hungarian sucks even more than my English, but hey, this gives me some room for improvement, which is always a good thing. And even though my Hungarian sucks, I would say that it's still better than that of 99.9% of all other Germans. So, Borat Lakások is something I would normally translate as friends' apartments. But it also has a different meaning, because Borat not only means friend, it also means monk. And these are actually places where some monks lived in the Middle Ages. And I see we are already approaching the first of these, Borat Lakások. So as you can see, these are kind of caves which are built into the rock. And it is a very special kind of rock, relatively soft, and I will give you some more information about that a little bit later. You have to know that these walls here are not really original. They have been built much later in the 20th century to prevent these caves from breaking down, because I think the three caves are still there and some others have been broken down already. So to prevent that from happening to the others, they have made these walls, you see. Okay, here already comes the second one. I have to say that currently the place is quite crowded, and unfortunately I really hate to film when other people are watching. So again, these walls, these stone walls, like this column here, are not really original. They have been built much later in the 20th century to prevent this whole thing from breaking down. But what you can see here is the original. I hope it's not too dark here, so you can see anything. So here is one that has already broken down and you're not able to get in here. Let's try to film a little bit. Okay, Not sure if you can see very much. And I think in a moment we should get to the final one. Okay, no, that's probably not it. Okay, there are some stairs going up, yeah. So this should be the third of the Barat-Lakashov, which are still preserved. Okay, there's a little room. And what you hopefully can see here, this is probably some kind of altar. As I said, the people who built this in the 11th century were monks, Greek Orthodox monks, I think. And of course, they were not just monks, they were eremites. Or hermits, which means they tried to get away as much as possible from other people, so to say, practice some social distancing. Of course, their main reasons seemed to be religious, but then if you think the Middle Ages were also a time of the plagues. I have to say that when the bubonic plague struck Europe, it was at a time when these caves already have been built. It was in the 13th century and not in the 11th century. But I think that even in the 11th century, even people in the Middle Ages realized that the closer they get to other people, the more likely it is to get some infectious diseases. And maybe this also was one of the reasons why they distanced themselves from the rest of society, not only the religion. Let me talk about these rocks a little bit more. As you can imagine, for monks in the Middle Ages with quite limited technology, the rocks have to be relatively soft for them to build caves like this. And yes, these rocks are relatively soft. I think I already mentioned that most of the hills in this area are or have volcanic origin. And this is also the case here. So these rocks here are not basalt or something like that. I think that's the English name. It's called a pyroclastite, which means that it's a sediment of the volcanic ashes that came down after the explosion to the ground. And as you can see, it consists of this more or less gray stuff, but also includes some red and yellowish stones. So the yellowish stones are limestones, which come from the Triassic time, and the red one is a typical sandstone from the end of the Perm area, which ended about 250 million years ago. And this was way before the time the volcanism started here, which was only about 4 to about 10 million years ago. So these rocks, the limestone and the sandstone, were thrown up by some volcanic explosion together with magma and basaltic stones and volcanic ashes, and they created this relatively soft sediment of which a large part of the Tihany Peninsula consists. This is, I'm not sure if you're interested in geology, most people are not, but just in case. So what I'm going to do now is I will continue walking so we can get a little bit more, a little bit higher up that hill, basically on the top of these rocks, and from there we should have quite a good view to Lake Balaton and the whole surroundings. I mean, you can also see Lake Balaton from here, maybe through the trees. It's much better in winter when there are no leaves, but I think you can see it. Okay, so let's continue. So here I am, almost at the top of this hill. You can have a beautiful view on the northeastern part of Lake Balaton. And the caves, the Borat Lakashok, are down there, right below me. Okay, so yeah, I think I'll go back and let's see if I'm gonna show you anything else, if I find it interesting. Oh, it's quite slippery here, so, and I definitely don't have the right shoes for hiking. These are the sandals which I'm wearing all the time when I'm in Hungary in summer. So what you can see here is probably one of the caves which have broken down. I think this happened in the early 19th century, but you still can see some remains of the cave. I'm back at the first of the caves where I had to stop filming in the beginning because a big crowd was coming in. So this might be the most interesting of the three. It consists of two parts. This is a small one. And look at these kind of shelves in the wall. I don't know what they were used for. Maybe they were really just shelves to put some things on them. But these point to the eastern direction, so it might also have been some kind of little altar, because you know that the people who made these things were monks, And here, look at this huge piece of sandstone, which is embedded in the volcanic ashes. So let's go to the next one. So I would say that this is the biggest one. And here, so what you can see here is obviously an altar. It also points to the eastern direction. And again, we have these little shells in the wall, which might also have some religious purpose, but could also be something completely different. What's interesting here, for a long time I've been wondering what that is. Looks like some kind of bathtub or something like that. I really have no idea. I'm on my way back to where I parked my bike. The whole tour can be done in less than an hour, I think. So you walk about 15 minutes up. You have maybe 30 minutes to explore the caves and another 15 minutes to walk back down. So it's no big deal. You can do it with kids as well. The only slightly different part of the hike is this staircase, or I should better say it used to be a staircase in some time. And okay, so here we have this spring, which currently doesn't seem to have water in it. It called Zipran Forage. Forage means spring. And okay, it's more or less dried out. I think that the monks also have been using this water from this spring for drinking, because as far as I know, it's the only spring that usually is available the whole year on this peninsula. Okay, I'm not sure if I'm on the right. Yes, I think I'm on the right way. So okay, somehow looks like I took a different way when I came up. Yeah, here we are. Okay. So when I walked up, I took this staircase, which has much better quality. But if you walk up here, you do not see this spring. Okay, so I think that's it from Boddart Lakashok. I hope to see you next time. And bye-bye.